guy is Vadim. Vadim, he's a co-founder of Percona since 2006 and serves as Chief Technology Officer. He leads Percona Labs, which focuses on technology research and performance evaluation of Percona and third-party products. Percona Labs designs non-gimmick tests of hardware, file systems, storage engines, and databases that surface the standard performance and functionality. He also CC authored the book High Performance MySQL Optimization, Backups, and Replication. He'll be talking about NoSQL on MySQL, MySQL Document Store. Please help me welcome Buddy.
Replication and sharding, which are part of scaling out approach. about the initial design for MongoDB. And it deploys features which actually allows the scale. So it's kind of first idea of MongoDB, how to scale multiple systems. So when you choose between two technologies, you might want to answer a bunch of questions. And first question which comes to mind is, what technology you really know, and what technology your team know better, and what your team is capable of handling? Because both MySQL and MongoDB, in my opinion, very capable databases, and your personal experience and your personal preference actually might help to deploy and to use this technology a lot. Second question is, what data model you want to follow? If you're more in a relational database world, MySQL would be an obvious choice. But if you're more document-based, then it's better to use MongoDB. Even MySQL has document store capabilities starting in MySQL 5.7, and even better, better support coming MySQL 8.0. MongoDB is still being a leader and they provide much better capabilities to handle document based workflow. Next question is how your data is used. If data belongs to single application, then a JSON model is kind of more expressive and helps you, might be helpful to store your application data structure, and you might not really need schema design, and you might throw a lot of documents into head storage. Then this first choice is for MongoDB users. But if you were, in our opinion, if your data shared between multiple applications, you need to have some kind of agreement or some kind of protocol of communication between applications. And the database schema, relational structure, being such a protocol which allows you to share and standardize your data access. In this case, relational databases are more appropriate. Transactions. If you need a full transactional support or multiple statements in a single transaction, MySQL is a much better choice for this case. If you need transactional support and you need to use documents, then MySQL 5.7 is document store. It might be very helpful. But if you don't need a transaction much, MongoDB with its scaling out capabilities might be much better. It can provide atomic document updates. But if you're looking for full-scale transactions, MongoDB might not be a great tool. Another question to consider joins your SQL statements. Do you use some advanced multiple tailable joins in your queries? Then MySQL is much more capable and powerful in this area. This is MongoDB provides some special operators, lookup and graph lookup, in its aggregational framework, which can be actually working quite well in parallel. So, if you don't need joins, if your application mostly simple lookups, maybe some filter and sort operations, then MongoDB, MySQL is very well in this process. Scaling. How do we plan to scale our application? So if you expect that a single server will be good enough for you, if you think you can throw enough hardware into your database layer, MySQL works well. And nowadays it's very well optimized to use multiple CPU cores. It can use a lot of memory. It's designed to use very fast storage. If you plan for a massive scaling out, if you plan to use 10, 20, hundreds of servers, if you expect your application to grow this way, then automatic sharding in MongoDB works much better. Duplication features in MongoDB much easier to use. Even though there for in MySQL world there's some automatic solution like Vitess kind to area, still MySQL Edge is much harder to scale up. And large scale aggregation. MongoDB has a aggregation framework which allows you parallel processing. And if you scale on multiple tens of hundreds of boxes, you can do aggregation pretty much in a parallel. It provides a very well designed business intelligence connector and provides application to Hadoop. On MySQL side, it is less capable. When you execute a query in MySQL, it is handled only in a single thread. So very complicated aggregation sorting queries might be a problem for MySQL. Even though there are some more advanced, more analytical oriented solutions come into play, like MariaDB, previously known as InfiniDB, and ClickHouse. I will talk about ClickHouse tonight. You may come to my talk about ClickHouse if you're interested about the technology. So this technology designed to eliminate MySQL short spanning and provide much better analytical capabilities and performance for relational database world. And MySQL is also capable to
arbitrary column names and values.
that's kind of makes MongoDB much more attractive for applications to developer which don't want to think much in advance. What kind of columns, what kind of data types are there? Just insert my data, then I will be able to do that later. And then to show an example how to find find a role by some specific criteria again. In MySQL, you execute very structured SQL query or an SQL standard. On MongoDB, you use a command find and just provide columns you're looking for. Configuration file, well, MySQL, MyCNF follows usually traditional config file formats where you have categories and then equals. And the MongoDB you provide more, it's a YAML structure config file. File documents in databases. Actually, both technologies provide very similar way to access all the kind of databases and tables you have. It seems MongoDB, well, I say MongoDB took after MySQL because MySQL is much older and MongoDB much younger. So you can use a show, use commands to see the databases and tables and collections for both databases. What about storage engines? Well, both databases are known to support multiple storage engines for MySQL, MyDB, TopDB, MyRocks coming soon in different variation of MySQL. And what's interesting in MySQL, you actually can use multiple storage engines at the same time. While for MongoDB, very old and very well-known MAP technology, but recently it's been replaced for more capable, more robust transactional provider target engine. And in Percona version of MongoDB, you provide the Percona memory engine, and they also have MongoRocks RocksDB variation for MongoDB. The limitation of MongoDB is that you can choose only one storage engine per server, and you cannot have a mix of different engines for different tables. Show process list, this is how you see what's going on in your server right now. You can see MongoDB kind of is more verbose and provides more information about currently running queries. This is how you would grant access for different users for the indexes. Both MySQL and MongoDB provide capability to create index on your tables, and this is how you can see what indexes are available for your tables. With a difference again for MySQL, you use a standard SQL language to provide to create new index. And what's interesting for MongoDB, MongoDB actually supports sorted indexes. Your index can be sorted in one direction or another. And when you create that index, you can specify state. It's kind of a little bit a cryptic way to, if you specify state one, it is sorted one way. If you specify state minus one, it's sorted in another way. While MySQL supports only one directional sorting for your indices. the user feature named slow prologue. It is a great feature to provide to perform a performance diagnostic if something goes slow on an unexpected on the server. You can enable a slow query log and see actually what queries cause a lot of most problems on your server. Both MySQL and MongoDB provides the ability to perform profiling and they see most intrusive queries. While MongoDB being more flexible, and you actually can see that information online. While with MySQL, you need to use third-party tools to analyze your file, your query is stored in a separate file. You need to perform another operation to performance troubleshoot your server. This is just an example. If you want to migrate for MySQL to MongoDB, actually there's a very efficient way to do that, especially with MySQL 5.7 and the JSON function in MySQL 5.7. You can export your data into JSON from other file and they actually can load multiple data in parallel. If you're thinking about using time to experiment with MongoDB, I recommend obviously consider trying to use Performance Server for MongoDB. It comes with a great list of features. First, it's 100% compatible with the MongoDB Community Edition. We provide open source alternatives to MongoDB Enterprise features. And we also include MongoRocks based RocksDB engine, and also we put Performa memory engine and, into our distribution. And we provide additional functionality like data masking, very something, and hot backup for Wild Tiger and MongoRocks. And this is just to show some benchmarks and the capabilities of our engine. So, for example, if you want to store your data into memory, you can get much better and stable throughput comparing with the standard traditional Wild Tiger engine for MongoDB. And then same with MongoRocks. With MongoRocks, we able in a very wide, heavy intensive application, be able to achieve much stable throughput comparing to the standard lifetime. Well, this I think that's all that I wanted to tell today about MySQL against MongoDB. I'm ready to take questions if you have any. Yes, your question.
How about typical protocols and procedures in place to ensure data integrity, like two-phase commits, rollbacks, stuff like that? Are those present in MySQL as well as MongoDB?
So, well, question was what about data integrity in the transactional support and interface commit? I would say MySQL supports much better. MySQL can provide you foreign key constraints and again transactional. MySQL has support for two-phase commits, while MongoDB I would say quite limited in this area. Okay, any other?